Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in this video we will study some of the features of the 8086 microprocessor. So let us start with our topic. The 8086 microprocessor, it is an enhanced version of the 8085 microprocessor. When 8085 was developed, this microprocessor was having some limitations, like the multiplication and the division operations, they cannot be performed with 8085. Also, the 8085, it executes only one instruction at a time, so its speed was slow, also the size was more. So all these limitations were covered up in the 8086 microprocessor. So in this video, we are going to study some features of this 8086. So first, we can say that it is an enhanced version of 8085 microprocessor. This 8086 microprocessor, it was designed by Intel in 1976, okay? Designed by Intel. The 8085 microprocessor, it was an 8-bit microprocessor, okay? Now, when the data increases, the size of the data increases, so the microprocessor also has to increase its size. So, this 8086 microprocessor, it is a 16-bit microprocessor. Means it can handle data which is of 16 bits, okay? And the data, it is will be in the binary form, that is in the form of zeros and ones. So 16 bit of data can be handled by this microprocessor. That is why it is known as a 16 bit microprocessor. Also, this microprocessor, it has the registers which are of 16 bits. That is why also it is known as a 16-bit microprocessor. Now this 8086, it has address lines and data lines just like the 8085. So the address line of 8086 microprocessor, it is 20 address lines are there. Starting from A0 to A19. So we have the 20 address lines here and data lines, it has 16 data lines. Starting from D0 to D15. Okay, so it has 20 address lines and 16 data lines. Now address lines, they are used to carry the address of the memory locations, and the data lines, they are used to transfer the data from or transfer or receive the data. So it can receive 16-bit data also here, and the addresses of the memory location, it will be of 20 bits. Now, as the data bus of the 8086 microprocessor, it is of 16 bits, so it can read and write the data to a memory location or to an input-output ports. Either 16-bit data can be read and written or 8-bit data at a time. So if the microprocessor, it is handling an 8-bit data, then it can use these 8 lines only, and if it wants to communicate with using the 16-bit data, then it can use all the 16 data lines. Okay, now we have the 20 address lines. Okay, so how much memory size will this 8086 microprocessor will have? raised to the power 20, it will be equal to 1 MB. So we can say that the memory size of this 8086 microprocessor or the memory locations it can handle, these are of 1 megabyte. Okay, if you remember in 8085 we were having 64 kilobytes of memory and we were having 16 address lines. So here the address lines are increased, so the addressing power has also increased, so it can address up to 1 megabyte of memory. Okay, next we have the 8086 microprocessor. It is a 40 pin IC. And it operates at plus 5 volt power supply. Frequency range of the 8086 microprocessor is 6 to 10 megahertz. It can support K input output ports. Now these were the some of the features like 40, that what are the pin numbers and at which frequency it is operating, what is the power supply and frequency range also we have mentioned here. Now this 8086 microprocessor, it comes in 3 versions. And these 3 versions, the difference between the 3 versions is of the frequency range. Okay, so first we have 8086, which operates at a frequency range of 5 megahertz. Then we have 8086-2, which operates at 8 megahertz. And then we have 8086-1. Which operates at 10 megahertz. So the difference between the 3 versions is of the operating frequency. The lowest version, it operates at 5 megahertz, then 8, then 10 megahertz. Okay. Now the instruction set of the 8085 microprocessor, it was having 75 instructions which allow the microprocessor to perform various arithmetic and logical operations like addition, subtraction and also like logical AND, logical OR, logical exclusive OR. All the arithmetic and logical operations can be performed, but only 2 operations like multiplication and division, they were not the 8085 was not able to perform the multiplication and division. But the instruction set of 8086, it is very powerful and it can perform the operations like multiplication and division. So it has a powerful instruction set. So it has a powerful instruction set which provides multiplication and divisions operation also. Next feature of 8086 is that it supports 2 modes of operation. One is the maximum mode and other is the minimum mode. Now maximum mode, it is suitable for the multiprocessor system, whereas the minimum mode, it is suitable for the single processor only. Okay, so we can write here that maximum mode system having multiple processors. So it is suitable where in the applications or in the systems which are involving multiple processors. Whereas minimum mode, it is suitable for system having a single processor. So these are the two modes of operation of 8086 microprocessor. Next feature is that this 8086, it consists of 29,000 transistors. Next, it has 256 vectored interrupts. There were various types of interrupts. In 8085, the number of interrupts was limited, whereas in 8086, it has 256 vectored interrupts. In 8085, we were having the arithmetic and logical unit, we were having the accumulator registers, okay. So the registers, they were of 8-bit registers, whereas in 8086, we were having 16-bit registers. So here we can say that it has a 16-bit arithmetic and logical unit, that is ALU. The registers are also 16-bit. It has internal data bus also and external data bus also. Okay. And because it is having two data buses, which are internal data bus and external data bus, the amount of data it also handle more, 16-bit data it can handle. So it has a faster processing than the 8085 microprocessor. Now we have the address and the data lines. The address lines are 20 address lines, so A0 to A19 we have, and data lines are from D0 to D15. Now the address and the data lines, they are multiplexed with each other. So we have address and data lines multiplexed. Means we have AD0 to AD15 and A16 to A19, they are the higher order address buses. So the address and the data lines, they are multiplexed with each other, means that the 16 address lines, they can be used as data lines also, and A16 to A19, they are the higher order address lines. Okay. Now, the next feature of 8086 that distinguishes it from the 8085 is that in 8085, only one instruction is executed at a time. Means first the instruction will be fetched, then it will be decoded, and then it will be executed. Whereas in the 8086 microprocessor, because its processing speed is very fast, so it can have six instructions which can be kept in a queue. First instruction will be executed, and the next six instructions, they will be in a queue. So this helps in the fast execution of the program. Like if their program is having many instructions in it, so six instructions can be at a time fetched by the microprocessor. So we can say there that 8086 has an instruction queue. So 8086 microprocessor, it has a special feature which is known as the instruction queue, and this instruction queue is capable of storing six instructions byte from the memory, resulting in faster processing. So when the first instruction is being executed, other six will be in the queue. So the time taken to first fetch and then decode, then execute, that will be reduced because 6 instructions at a time they are fetched. Okay. Now 8086 is also has a feature which is known as pipelining. So this 8086 microprocessor, it uses two stages of pipelining. First is the fetch state and second is the execute stage. So in the fetch stage, 6 instructions they are fetched, and in the execution stage, those 6 instructions then they will be executed. Okay. So there are two stages of the pipelining, fetch stage and execute stage. The function of fetch state is to prefetch the 6 instructions. So the function of fetch state is to prefetch up to 6 bytes of instructions and store them in the queue in order to speed up the instruction execution. So to speed up the to increase the speed of the microprocessor, 6 instructions are fetched at a time. Okay, and then we have the execute stage. The execute stage then executes these instructions. So these were some of the features of 8086 microprocessor. We studied that this is a 16-bit microprocessor, a 40-pin IC, which is operating in the frequency range from 6 to 10 megahertz. And at plus 5-volt power supply, it is working. It has 256 interrupt vectors, vectored interrupts. Then it has 29,000 transistors there. It operates in two modes, maximum mode and minimum mode. Maximum mode is suitable for multiple processor, and minimum mode is suitable for single processor. Then we studied the special feature of 8086, that it has an instruction queue in which 6 bytes of instructions, they can be prefetched so that to speed up the processing of the microprocessor 8086. Okay. Then we studied that it has two stages of pipelining, fetch stage and the execute stage. So these were the features of 8086 microprocessor. So I hope that this topic is clear to you. Thank you.